Well, it's the first morning for Cody and I down here in Texas. We're already hunting. We're about 60 miles west of Wichita Falls, Texas, down here in a town called Kroll. And we're hunting on Ragedy Creek Ranch this weekend, and potentially hunting some black buck and awdad. Two pretty tough animals to take with a bow and arrow, but just as we were setting up to film this, you know, we got an awesome looking drop off back here where we can watch this whole bottom. Black buck, when I'm hunting, came up about 120 yards back behind us, and we just kind of had to watch him ease off a hunt with bows this weekend, and hopefully everything will work out, but if it don't, we may have to pull a rifle out or something, but we're definitely going to try it with a bow first. And it's some gorgeous, gorgeous property, but it's tough hunting too. I mean, it's a lot of area to look over, and your viewpoint is also a viewpoint for the animals. It's not very tough for them to see you silhouetted up on top of a hill, so you kind of got to be careful when you're doing your lookout, but we're definitely looking forward to a pretty good weekend, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, I think it's going to be nice, especially since we've already seen animals. Every time we've been out here, we've seen some nice animals. Like Cody said, though, their viewpoint is like ours, and typically, you know, you'd get down and train like this and just want to stop because there's not trees big enough that you can hang a stand in. And I think they have a couple tripod stands out here, but Rusty said they weren't ready to come into the water holes. So we're just going to have to find a place to set up. You know, maybe on one of these ridges just to see, find a pattern, which is hard for odd and black buck.
Yeah, they just move constantly.
And then we'll just have to get set up and go bow hunt. And that's part of bow hunting. It's a challenge. And maybe getting some to walk out in front of us where Cody or I can get a shot. But if not, it's going to be fun, man.
Yeah, and this is definitely some awesome hunting, and it's definitely hunting. Mm-hmm. So let's sit back, see if we can't spot some more animals, and we'll make our next move from there. Ragedy Creek.
Well, sometimes when you're walking out in the wild, you can stumble upon some nice little sweets, natural fruit.
Plum.
These are plums.
He's not talking about himself either.
And the good things about these, you know, it's pretty hot out here. West Texas, late June actually, it's almost July. So it's nice being able to walk around and pick one of these up. And
you gonna try it? Good?
That was a good one.
All right.
These yellow ones aren't ripe yet. Found a dark red one though.
Real good.
There you go. You get used to seeing all these mesquites and them plum.
It's like heaven. If there's only water found out here.
Yeah. Good way to get you some water. Dehydrated.
Yep. One of these days I'll learn to carry a water bottle around.
Let's go harvest something.
Oh, we did some bow hunting yesterday. And kind of
Right now we're set up on this point, overlooking where these rams are, about 200, 250 yards out. There's a lot of nice rams over there, a couple Texas dolls, and a full horn. But one thing you want to do is you don't want to rush, especially with these exotics. We're just going to set up. The black wine that I was looking at went behind a tree up in this ravine. So either way, if he walks out, he was kind of leading the pack. If he walks out, I may be able to get a shot up on top of this ridge, or if he walks down, and they'll be broken up. One thing about these, especially the rams, when it comes to exotics, are that anytime you try to get close and they know you're close and you're pressuring them, they like to bunch together. And then you can't take a shot because you're just shooting through and hitting another animal, wounding an animal, or killing two animals. That's just not a good situation. So we're just gonna sit up here and be patient. You know, that's part of hunting. Let's see if we can't get a good shot. Cat and mouse game, man. We'd follow them, they'd run off. We saw those Texas dolls, and those ones who'd kind of been watching us on that ridge. They took off. We saw these guys, they were popping out of holes. You know, probably had maybe like a 20-yard opening. He walked off, nice black and white, cordoned away. Made a good shot, and he's down, too. I mean, he's down.
Well, here he is. This is a big ram. This is the best ram I've ever shot. And I'm for sure going to take this guy to the taxidermy, have him mounted. But a great hunt, Rusty.
Cody.
Thank you, man. We appreciate it.
You're quite welcome.
Cody and I have been on a lot of hunts, and this is probably one of the most exciting hunts I've been on, just because out here in West Texas, out at Ragged Creek, the terrain is awesome. It's a totally different hunt, especially being from Oklahoma. It's something, you know, we get into Western Oklahoma, we kind of see some stuff like this, but just the type of hunt that it was on here in the summertime, just everything worked out great. Had a good time and, you know, got really excited, you know, probably on the video earlier, you can tell, because, man, after my first shot, I was just heart pounding and, you know, ready to get down this hill. And we did a little walking the other day, you know, started out trying to use bow and decided that archery, especially this time of year with how thick everything is, that a rifle would be the best choice. But
we did a lot of walking.
Yeah,
a lot of walking.
About 6 miles, but I needed the exercise. I've been sitting around since summer started. But I think we're going to get this guy back. I'm going to go clean him up, and then Cody's going to head out and see if he can't get on possibly a black buck, and see what we can do from there. And that's another awesome animal, too. We saw him twice yesterday.
Right.
But, man, they're just so
they're pretty
shy.
Elusive.
They're timid, yeah. Elusive, that was the word I was looking for. They just kind of mosey on, and it's easy to lose some things out here.
Especially being the summer, you know, all this stuff has got all the mesquite have the leaves on them, and everything is so thick down here during the summertime, and so it makes it for an interesting hunt. And you feel like you're doing something when you can find a single animal that you're looking for, and so we're excited about it. I think it's going to work out pretty good, and the whole thing's been exciting.
Oh,
Cody,
yeah.
That's a great.
Every time
ramp.
We come out here, we have a good time. We are taking a couple of young ladies and a couple of guys out hunting with us, and every time we come down, man, have a good time. Hospitality's always great, but let's get this guy loaded up, and Cody, you get out walking around again.
All right.
Let's do it.
Well, we're back out this afternoon. We had a great morning hunt. Had to get started a little later because it was so foggy we couldn't really see anything, but we're back out this afternoon. Cody got a great black Hawaiian this morning, and we spotted a nice black buck out here. There's two of them. One of them's really nice, and I'm hoping I can get on him. We're going to use this high vantage point this evening to kind of wait for them as the day goes on. It gets a little later. These black bucks tend to come out a little bit more. And we're going to see if we can't spot him from up here. Hopefully get a good shot on him. I'm excited, and just kind of, it's a waiting game and a patience thing where you know, you never know whether he's going to come out or not. But keep your hopes high and always be ready, because you don't ever know when he's going to show up, especially in this country and this much area. So we're going to set up and just kind of glass and look and wait, and hopefully everything turns out for the best. Let's see how it works out. Looks like it could be them.
Quail population isn't hurting out here. Seen more quail than I have my whole life.
I've seen a lot of them.
Mm-hmm.
All over the roads and everything.
Don't normally see them hanging up in trees, huh? Go flush him.
Oop. We had a great time out here at Ragedy Creek this weekend. Things worked out great. Cody got a black Hawaiian this morning. Second morning of the hunt, and things just went awesome. It was one of those once in a lifetime type things, and just perfect situations, and everything worked out great. However, on the other hand, the black buck that I've been looking for is staying pretty hidden and doing a good job at it. And we've got a little bit of daylight left, so we're gonna sit it out and see if we can't see him. But we've had a great time down here at Ragedy Creek. Everything's always fun. The hospitality's great, and you know, it's just not all the time that you get to come out and hunt some stuff like this. The terrain is awesome, and it's always got something new in store for you. So also, we want to thank Chase for taking us out and guiding us around this weekend. We had a great time with him, and he's always a hoot to hang out with. But anyway, while we still got a little light, we're going to keep looking. But as it sits right now, He's going to be here for the next time we come down, and hopefully I'll get another shot at him. Yeah. Until next time, let's hit the water.